Hey everybody, my name's Alison and today I will be showing you how to install and configure the vsftpd server on CentOS 7. One of the most convenient methods of uploading files to the server is using an FTP server. The vsftpd server is often used for many different operating systems and it's considered one of the most secure FTP servers available. In order to complete this install, there are a few steps we will perform. First, we'll install the vsftpd service. Next, we will configure vsftpd settings within the configuration file. Then we will have to restart the service. Finally, the service has to be allowed within firewall D. Let's get started by installing vsftpd on the server. Before you install new software, it's best practice to run updates on the server. You can perform the needed updates by running yum-y update. After running the updates, we're ready to install vsftpd and any required packages. To install vsftpd, go ahead and run yum-y install vsftpd. Once the vsftpd install is complete, you'll want to edit the configuration file for the service. Go ahead and open the file with your favorite file editor. My favorite file editor is Vim. Once you're in the configuration file, you'll want to edit a couple of lines. First, you'll want to disallow anonymous logins, which allows unknown users to access files via FTP. Go ahead and find the anonymous enable entry and set it to no. The second entry to edit is the local enable setting. This setting allows your regular user accounts to function as FTP accounts. Search for the entry local enable and change the setting to yes. Additionally, if you want the local user to be able to write to a directory, you'll want to change the write enable setting to yes. Find the write enable setting inside of the configuration file and make the change. An important configuration to change is true local user. By enabling this setting, you'll be containing the local user to access only the user's home directory. Go ahead and set the true local user setting to yes. Make sure you save the changes you just made to the config file and then exit the file. Great job! We're almost done with installing and configuring vsftpd. In order for the changes to be initiated, you'll need to restart and enable the vsftpd service. The first step is to restart the service with the following command: systemctl restart vsftpd. Next, we want to set the service to start at boot. In order for that to be set for the future, you will want to enable the service with the following command: systemctl enable vsftpd. The last step is to allow vsftpd through the firewall. In order to allow the default FTP port 21, through firewall D, you will want to run the following commands inside of the terminal. Lastly, reload the firewall. And that's it! You should now have vsftpd installed, set up, and configured on your server. If you followed these directions, you should now be able to log into the server via FTP. Please note, if you have a hardware firewall in addition to the server's software firewall, you may need to adjust that too. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed our video about how to install and configure vsftpd on CentOS 7. For more how-tos and tutorials, visit our knowledge base at liquidweb.com/kb or our YouTube channel at youtube.com/user/liquidwebinc.